最近，中共在海外设立110之事，引发西方国家的密切关注。目前已经有14个国家展开调查，并且采取行动，还有新发现的16个110将陆续的被曝光。我们来看加拿大记者李威发来的报道。
好的，谢谢主播。人权组织保护卫士7日更新了消息，已经有14国政府开始调查中共的海外警站，新发现的16个警站稍后会公布其详情。此前，爱尔兰和荷兰政府已经下令要求其关闭，加拿大奇警也已经对中共110警站展开了调查。有人权监察专家作证，中共海外警站长期监管和骚扰异议人士，呼吁政府要立法对其监管。
They can intimidate people like us. I've been living in Canada for many decades. Now I feel frightened. I need to install a camera out in my house. They actually Chinese police, so they should be considered as Asian. So there should be legislation that they need to inform Canadian government that they are Asian.
加拿大全球事务部警告，这将成为非常严肃的加中交涉话题。同时，有中国问题研究专家呼吁。加拿大的司法系统必须要根除这类外国秘密警察的行动。
The notion that they are simply there so that Chinese people can renew their driving licenses and so forth is a nonsense. That sort of thing is properly done through the consulate if need be. Our law and justice systems need to root out these clandestine police operations. We can't have other police forces running around in Canada, not just from China, but from anywhere else.
上个月，美国法院起诉了7名中国人，指控他们对一名来自中国的美国居民进行了骚扰和监视，并且曝光了中共在加拿大多伦多协调了其中的某些行动。加拿大王家奇警已经开始调查这些非法的活动，并且提醒民众，如果受到类似的骚扰和恐吓，应该立即报警。好的，现在把镜头交还给演播室。